If you can smell your long tones, it's time to show your trumpet some love. Summer and winter break are great times to give your trumpet a full bath. It's easy to do, it's practically foolproof, it'll make your instrument look better, sound better, and last longer. Now the interwebs are full of how to maintain or how to bathe your trumpet videos, so I figured one more won't hurt anything. This is how I've been doing it for about 25 or 30 years, and so far I've not lost a trumpet yet. You can soak the instrument in your bathtub, however I like to use a smaller container so that I don't occupy the bathtub for several hours or waste a bunch of hot water. The container I use is big enough to hold one or two trumpets or a flugelhorn. You can find a container that suits one trumpet pretty easily, and when all your cleaning supplies dry out, you can use that container to store everything until next time. You'll need a handful of supplies, they're pretty cheap and they last a long time. Here's what I use. A mouthpiece brush, a valve casing brush or a small bottle brush, an old toothbrush or your little brother's new one, a cleaning snake, gentle dish soap, the degreasing kind, the kind they use on ducks and birds and whatnot. I'd avoid anything with bleach in it. A washcloth, probably an old one, it's going to get messy. A towel to dry everything unless you just happen to like water spots on your trumpet. And you'll need valve oil and slide grease when we put everything back together. You can find most of these things in a cleaning kit from a music store, or you can piecemeal them in online or at Walmart. All right, the first step is to take this thing apart. Be very careful, try not to drop anything, and take note of how easily your valve caps come off. They're not supposed to be difficult to pull off, and they certainly shouldn't be difficult when you put them back on. Be careful. I'll start with pulling out the valves. I'm going to lay them aside. We'll get back to them in a minute. And this is probably the worst thing to drop on a trumpet. So make sure they don't roll around, or you might want to put a towel down wherever you're putting the valves so they stay put. And everything else goes in my tub. All right, I'm gonna fill the tub with hot water, like really hot shower hot, not scalding, but I think warmer hot water works better to break up the grease. This may take a little while. The water is almost to the top of the bell. This is when I'm going to add my dish soap. I don't like to do it at the beginning because bubbles go everywhere. It's kind of hard to tell how high the water is and all that. All right, so a little bit of my favorite bird degreaser. Pretty generous. It'll wash out. Ooh, bubbles. Lovely. And as you can see, in addition to getting kind of heavy, the bin is almost full and just about to cover the top of my bell. There we go. Look at that, huh? Shoot the suds around a little bit. Oh, good times right there. All right. There you go. Now, I told you we're going to set the valves aside for a minute. Now we're going to attack those. What we don't need to do is spend much time on the top of the valve, the spring barrel, where the guide is and the little spring is inside, and we certainly don't need to take apart the top of the valve. The part that we need to make sure is clean is the gray stuff with the holes in it. And also, it's not a great idea to get the valve felts or corks at the top wet. It's not going to destroy them if they get wet, but you have to wait a long time for them to dry before you put the instrument back together, or they might get a little funky inside. So what I like to do is take a coffee cup, so that I'm going to fill the coffee cup with enough sudsy goodness to just cover the gray part of the valve. And it'll just come right out of here. Mmm. And I will put in there and let them think about what they've done for a while. Okay, that's the easy part. I'm going to let the instrument soak for a few hours. Let's say maybe an hour for every month you haven't bathed it. And through the magic of cinema, when I come back, 6 hours will have passed and we'll get on with things. Oh, we're done. So the first thing I want to do now is I want to make sure that I can't accidentally drop any small bits and pieces down the sink. So I'm going to use a sink strainer or something just to kind of clog the hole a little bit. Just in case. in no particular order. I'm going to pull these things out, use my fancy brushes, and clean all the crooks and crannies. It's kind of fun. What's first? So what I'm going to use on some of the slides is maybe the end of my snake to get in there really well. You could also use your mouthpiece brush. You could also use your valve casing brush if it fits. And certainly for the insides, any kind of brush or your toothbrush will work great to get in there, etc. And then for the finish and cleaning off grease, I will just use my dirty old rag to clean that out. I'll do this for all of my slides and carefully lay them in the bottom of the sink. If you don't like the clinky sound, you could lay another towel in the sink if you like, but I don't think it hurts anything to do that. First valve and third valve slide need a little extra care because, as you know, they need to move really, really smoothly. If you feel like you're getting a little crustiness on your slides, here's a great trick that you can do at home that's not going to hurt anything nor cost a whole lot of money. Get a little baking soda and put baking soda on the slides and then put the slides back in the instrument and work those around a little bit. That baking soda is going to be a little crunchy. It's going to use the contact between the slides to rub off some of the particulate matter that may not come off easily with your washcloth. If you're going to do this, let's go ahead and do it at the beginning of the washing and not when we're putting the instrument back together so that we have a chance to get all the baking soda out of every tube and every port. We don't want the baking soda to migrate into the valve casings. That would be kind of problematic. Don't forget your bottom valve caps. They do collect a lot of gook and grossness. Take your toothbrush, put it in the cap, and just do a little circle. The cap will spin around real slow, the bristles will get in all the threads, and you'll have a nice clean cap when you're done. Okay, the mouthpiece. You don't need to wait every 6 months to clean your mouthpiece. I'd strongly recommend you leave a mouthpiece brush in your trumpet case, and maybe over a couple of days, just give it a quick clean. Take it to the water fountain and rinse it out real quick, and that'll help quite a bit. Quick rinse, and we're ready for high notes. Okay, that's all the bits and pieces of the trumpet. I'm going to rinse these off really well and go ahead and towel dry them and let them sit and dry out on the inside a little bit, and then we're going to move to the body of the instrument. No water spots. Okay, now for the body of the instrument. This is where we get to use all our brushes and toys. I'm going to send my trumpet cleaning snake through all the long tubes that I can. Be careful as you're heading toward the valve casing that you don't let the end of your brushes scratch the inside of the casing. You can turn the instrument up and down and you can see the edge of your brush going into the casing, and that's where you can stop. So I'll send the brush in just until it gets to the casing. Then I'm going to hold my finger at the end of the brush, the snake, and that way I can move in and out pretty quickly without accidentally going into the casing. Same thing for the third valve slide. Yeah, good stuff there. And first valve slides, same thing. Take a peek, make sure you're not going too far. And you know what? Second valve slide needs some love as well, so be careful. Go in just a little bit and loosen up the gook. Lead pipe. This is where all the fun stuff is. We'll send the snake through the lead pipe a couple of times, and we'll probably get some unfortunate stuff coming out the other end. Be careful where you splash this thing, okay? All right. Up and down. Pull it out a little bit. Go up and down. Pull it out a little bit. Go up and down. And you probably can't do this too many times. Okay. All right. I'm going to put the instrument in the tub. I'm going to send my snake down the bell all the way around to the first valve casing. Take a peek, make sure I don't go too far into the casing, and get as much of that loosened up as I can. Here we go. Oh yeah, good stuff. All right, here's a pro tip. We're going to take our valve casing brush and we're going to clean the casings underwater, because these little brushes can send all kinds of water shooting everywhere if we're not careful. So I'm just going to go ahead and put it in here. And straight in, so I don't get any metal on the casing. And I'm just going to go up and down. This will also take care of anything that I might have pushed into the casings as I was using the snake. So I'm going to do the casings last for that reason. Okay. So that's going to cover pretty much all the inside of the instrument. Now I'm going to take my toothbrush, if I can find it, and try and get some of the nooks and crannies on the outside of the instrument, especially where my hands make contact with the instrument over and over again. These are places that are very difficult to get your polishing cloth into, and etc. So we do as much of that as we can. And et cetera, you get the idea, running around. And then the last thing I'm gonna do is take my cloth and give the outside of the instrument as much attention as I can with the cloth and soapy water. Particularly, I like to spend a little time at the bottom of the bell where the water key tends to add a little extra crunchy to the bell. So as much of that as you can reach without hurting your fingernails or whatever. And because I tend to play with a lot of water shooting out of the horn, I'm gonna take my toothbrush, just hit the bottom bell around the bell rim wire as well. It tends to, in that little groove, kind of gets a little, I don't know, souvenirs of gigs past. Get the idea. One quick dunk, get all the stuff out of there. All right. And I didn't take a whole lot of time now, but you should take a little extra time around all of the slides and the ferrules. That's where you want to get as much of the old grease and slide oil off as you can. That's what the rag is for. It works really well. Okay, I'm going to rinse this all down, dry it off on the outside, and I'm going to put it down and let it rest a little bit and see if we can get some of the inside dried off. So spend a little time drying off the outside of the horn. It'll make your job a lot easier if you decide to hit it with polishing cloth later, because you won't have to contend with all the little water spots and all of that. So that's good. And then I'll let the horn dry probably for a few hours to let some of the inside dry out a little bit. You can certainly, I don't know, if you're impatient, you can take a hairdryer to it, or I don't know, set it out in the sun if you'd like. But, you know, it won't take that long. Let's face it, a little water in the inside of the horn is not a bad thing. It has water inside pretty much all the time. There you go. And last thing is I'm going to clean the valves. I'm going to take my mouthpiece brush and carefully get into the ports, the holes in the valve. Try not to put any metal or scratch anything else. There we go. And again, there's nothing to clean on the top part of the valve. It doesn't make contact with any of the valve casing. It generally does not collect any gook. Okay, carefully rinse that so that it don't wet the pads too much. Give her a careful shake, and put it to bed. There you go. Let it dry, come back in a couple hours, and we're going to put it back together. Again, magic of television. Okay. Let's pretend it's all good and dry on the inside. I'm gonna start reassembling the monster. By the way, this is a great time to take polishing cloth to the instrument before we put lubricants and grease on it and end up getting all the brown gook everywhere. So if you have a silver-plated instrument like mine, there are a lot of great treated cleaning cloths that do a nice job of taking off tarnish without dealing with any water or pastes or anything. So I'd suggest you use that. If you decide to go for a deep clean and wanna use a silver polish, make sure you get something for plated surfaces. Do not get a polish or a cream that's for solid silver, because there are abrasives in that will wear away your plating on your instrument. So, plated surfaces only. If you have a lacquered instrument or a brass colored instrument, just use a cleaning cloth that's made for lacquer instruments and you're good to go. With that finish, soap and water, a good job drying it, and one run with the cleaning cloth usually takes care of everything. So I'm going to start with all my slides, and I'm going to save the valves for last. For my first and third valve slide, I like to use a combination of slide grease with a drop or two of oil to loosen them up. As you know, those slides need to move very, very easily. For me, I've always found Vaseline works great. You can get this anywhere with SPF if you'd like, or you can go with a lanolin or a slide grease that the music store sells. They're all great. I just, when I run out of a slide grease, I can usually find this at a Walmart or a drugstore, and it's just a lot easier because I'm lazy. All right, I'll put a little bit of this Vaseline on the slide. You can rub it around a little with your finger. I do it just on the end because when I put the slide in the horn, the pipes are going to help take the Vaseline and travel into the ferrules a little bit better. So I'll do that on the inside tubes of the slides. A little dab will do you. Walk it around a little bit with the finger, and then I'll put it on. If your slides will work this way, you can cross the slides, put the bottom slide in the top and vice versa to help really evenly distribute that Vaseline. Put them on backwards, you can rotate them around. Anything that you can do to get the creamy Vaseline or slide cream to travel inside the instrument. Okay, when I do that, it's a little sluggish, but not much. You can see that it moves kind of by itself. Huh? All right, and then one little drop of valve oil right at the end, and then I will let that travel around a little bit, and it loosens right up, and you'll notice, I mean, that's like butter right there. We'll do the same thing for the first valve slide. Okay, everything's running great. Be careful at this point, because the valves aren't in, if your slides move really, really well, they will slide right off the trumpet and hopefully not onto the floor. So at this point, you might want to keep things a little close to the workbench, right? I'll put a little bit of Vaseline on the second valve slide, but I'll skip the oil. I don't need this thing to move very well. I kind of need to stay put. Run it around. Put it in the horn, move it in different directions, spread that Vaseline or slide grease everywhere that you can inside the little receivers. There we go. Any of it that's extra, wipe it off. And the same issue with my main tuning slide. I don't need it to fall out by itself either, so just slide grease on this. And to be quite honest, you probably can't do too much slide grease on the main tuning slide. It does tend to get frozen in place more often than it should. So I'm going to put a fairly generous amount on the slides. Now I have a reversed receiver, so I'm going to have to put grease on the other tube. Most of you will have two brown pipes there, and it works a little better. You can, again, switch those around, put the top one in the bottom receiver and vice versa to really work around the grease. Okay. And walk it around all over. Oh yeah, there we go. And then drive it on home. See, as some of the slide grease comes out, you can imagine if you hit that with your cleaning cloth, it would smear all over your horn. So like I said, do the polishing before you do the assembly. All right, bottom valve caps, they deserve a little bit of slide grease too, just so those threads don't freeze up as easily. So I put a little bit of slide grease on the inside of the cap. And then when I put it on, the grease is going to travel around the threads as I turn the cap around and around. Again, be careful. Don't cross thread these. Be gentle until it seats home, and then you're good to go. Last, we seat the valves. Make sure we got all the water off of them. Of course, you know, they do come in a certain order, so pay attention to the numbers on the valves. Number one goes closest to your nose, number three goes closest to the bell. I like to go ahead and seat them in. Don't put them all the way in yet, but let's go ahead and put them halfway in. I'm going to put a little valve grease on the inside of the caps, or if you want to put it on the threads themselves on the outside, that's fine too. But it'd be really nice if those didn't get stuck before the next time you clean your trumpet also. We kind of need those to come off. All right. I'm going to apply a couple of drops of valve oil to the gray part of the valve. Again, doesn't do you any good to put oil in the spring barrel because the spring barrel doesn't touch anything. So when you oil your valves, pull them out about halfway, put a few drops at the top of the gray section or the section with the big holes in it. All right, and then let them walk home. Okay, check that they're aligned, make sure they snap in, tighten, and you're good to go. All right, so if we don't count the time that I let this soak in the tub, cleaning the instrument inside and out takes about 30 minutes or even less, okay? And it's easier if you don't have to explain it as you go. So keep that in mind. It's not hard, it's practically foolproof, and it'll make the instrument last a lot longer, sound a lot better, and smell better too. I'll have some links in the description below to some cleaning supplies and other things, and let me know if you have any questions. Good luck.